How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Hogwarts Legacy, part number 2. Hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. I was blown away by that first video. Appreciate all the love and support on it. Keep it coming. I'm really excited to continue this series, so leave a like if you're enjoying it. Make sure to subscribe, and if you're feeling pretty crazy, go ahead and leave a comment down below. But with that being said, let's go ahead and jump in.
This is the right area. I wonder where the flying page is.
Revelio. Flying page must be around here somewhere.
Might some kind soul help me?
Are you all right?
Don't you know who I am? Zenobia Noak, the girl whom everyone at school hates for no reason.
Everyone hates you? Why?
Because Hogwarts is full of bullies and spoil sports. Leander Pruitt's one of the worst, that no-talent moon mind. I wanted to make some new friends, and so I brought my collection down to the common room. My gobstone collection, that is. I was hoping someone would want to play. Are you familiar with gobstones? Little balls, like marbles. Grand game. And if you lose, they spray you with a foul-smelling liquid.
Gobstones? Sounds like a fun challenge.
That's what I tried to tell everyone. People can be so cruel. Just because they're sprayed all over with smelly gobstone spit, it's their own fault for losing. Imelda is one of the worst losers. Everett and Astoria are terrible as well. And now those poor losers have taken my gobstones and hidden them in very high places all over the school.
Rather an overreaction on their part.
I'll say. Anyway, I can't work out how to get them back on my own. I don't think I know the necessary spells yet. I need someone, perhaps a selfless and talented fifth year, to help me.
Haven't you any friends at school?
Not really. Natty said hello once, but not a word since.
Do you have any suggestions on how to get your gobstones down from their hiding spots?
If I knew that, I'd get them myself. Whoever hid my gobstones that high got up there somehow.
I'll see what I can do.
I'd appreciate the help. If you do find all of my gobstones, do come and see me again. I'll be back to playing Snake Pit and Jackstone by myself in no time.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia. I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic.
Thank you.
That's it. Very good. If you would like to practice mending something, have a go with that broken statue in the alcove.
Repair reward.
It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover thought it too accurate and lashed out.
Revelio.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Revelio. Lumos.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide.
You might think.
Oh dear, I shall.
Is everything all right?
Oh, hello. Nice to see you again. Thank you for asking. And I'm afraid everything's not all right. I may be in a spot of trouble with the librarian. You might recall that I was trying to cast non-verbally when we met in the common room. Well, I mastered that, and now I've taken to creating my own charms. Thought I'd perfected my light as a feather charm to use on my library books. My arms get so tired carrying them around all day. But I must have confused the Latin word for feather with bird in my incantation, because when I opened my bag just now in the library, they literally took flight.
That sounds a rather complicated way to simply avoid carrying your books.
Possibly. But where's the fun in simplicity? New charms and spells have to come from someone. Why not me? I collect the books and remove the charm myself, except this isn't the first time one of my charms has threatened the peace of the library. Armeet told Madame Scribner they were my books flying around, so she said that if I caused her any more trouble, she'd write to my parents. Perhaps you could get them for me. There are only five. She won't be suspicious of a new student looking around.
I suppose I could help, if I have the time.
Oh, I'd very much appreciate it. One of the books is my diary. I'd rather it not fall into the wrong hands. If you could collect them and bring them to me, I can remove the charm.
I finally have an answer as to why that poor.
I hated learning banishment.
Thank you.
I'd swear we'd be more uplifted in potion.
I still can't manage to transfigure a match into a needle without catching it on fire.
Professor Weasley's already preparing me to take my place.
Well, fancy meeting you here.
Hello, Sebastian.
Ah, my new charge. I'm told you're in dire need of supplies, and I'm to accompany you into Hogsmeade for them. Is this your first foray into the village?
It is. I haven't left the castle since I arrived.
Well, I shall endeavour to be the very best of guides, then. Hogsmeade's a charming little place. Self-contained, too. We should be able to find you everything that you need. Shall we? I was glad Professor Weasley asked me to join you today.
As am I. Thank you, by the way.
Of course. You're the only one who's ever bested me in a duel. The way I see it, I'd be wise to keep an eye on you. Speaking of Weasley, she seems to have taken quite a shine to you.
Has she? That's nice to hear.
I'm still surprised that a professor would entrust me with anything. Given my detention record.
Spend a lot of time in detention, do you?
Just enough to keep me well-rounded.
Revelio.
Speaking of detention, this trip to Hogsmeade might have saved me from one.
Glad I could be of service.
Madam Scribner, the librarian, was on the hunt for me, as is often the case. Professor Weasley came to retrieve me, and I was able to convince old Scribner that I had somewhere to be.
So how did you manage to get on the librarian's bad side?
Well, I suspect it's a matter of differing opinions. She thinks I shouldn't be allowed in the restricted section, and I, on the other hand, am inclined to disagree. Oh, just one moment. This is an excellent spot to gather lacewing flies. They're pretty to look at. If you stew them long enough, they make a powerful potion ingredient. Merlin's beard from the Forbidden Forest. Look!
What's going on?
See for yourself. Quite a sight, isn't it? You certainly don't see that every day.
Do you think Poppy's already seen the hippogriffs?
Likely already named them too.
Prance, Hoof and Sugarfoot.
To the left is the Forbidden Forest. Out of bounds to all students.
Oh, hence the name.
Precisely. They think it's too dangerous. I think they need to have more confidence in our defensive abilities. Ah, you can see Hogsmeade just past those ruins up ahead. Have you had much of a chance to explore the castle?
A little. It's positively enormous.
It is that. I've been there 5 years and barely scratched the surface. Loads to see, places to discover.
Oh? Any you'd like to share with the class?
Perhaps one day. I can't go around telling you all my secrets now, can I? You still haven't told me how you became so good at dueling. I've always thought Thestral's pulling a carriage a bit grim. though I suppose most people don't actually see them at all.
But you can see them.
Unfortunately. But you've seen quite a bit yourself firsthand too. Most notably that dragon attack. Hopefully the rest of your year isn't as eventful.
Owls must be incredibly intelligent to deliver all those letters.
Mr. Moon! He's the Hogwarts caretaker. Looks a bit worse for wear. Hello, Mr. Moon. Have you met our new fifth year?
Pleasure! You might want to turn back, Mr. Sallow. Turn and run.
Is everything all right, sir?
Oh, look right at me! Eyes big as saucers!
What did, Mr. Moon?
Demi-guys. Ugly and airy and terrifying. I shall be at the castle where it's safe. Good luck to both of you.
A demi-guys. I don't know what he's putting in his pumpkin juice, but he's obviously had too much of it. I've never seen Mr. Moon in such a state. Mr. Moon is quite the character. My sister Anne thinks he's lovely, but I'd say he could improve a bit as a caretaker.
Oh, is your sister in Slytherin too?
She is, or rather, she was. She's not well at the moment, but she'll be better soon and back at Hogwarts. Honestly, if one could bottle the magic of this place, I don't know if it's the shops or the people, but there's just something about Hogsmeade. We all flock to
Ravenclaw.
So how would you like to do this? Weasley told me you had a list of things to get. A wand and some other bits.
Yes. Dittany seeds, some spellcrafts, and some potion recipes.
Perfect. Can't wait to see what you do with a new wand. And a short list gives you plenty of time to poke around the village. I just have to pop into a shop to find something for my sister. Let's meet up in the town circle when you're finished. Remember, have fun. It's Hogsmeade.
I'll be right with... Ah, it's you. Just a moment, please.
Hello, sir. I'm looking for...
For a new wand, yes. It's about time.
Yes, about time?
Well, you're our new fifth-year student, are you not? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you are. Gerbold Ollivander's the name. But of course, you'll have heard of the Ollivanders, I'm sure. Finest wand makers in the world. It's a pleasure to meet you, truly. Now, come with me. Let's find you the perfect wand, shall we? No, not you. Yes. Powerful core. 10.5 inches. You might do. Here, give this one a try. Well, go ahead, swish. How odd. Once more, come on, really swish it. Oh, dear. Well, this isn't a good match at all, is it? We'll find you something, not to worry. No, not you. Perhaps. Yes. A rare wood, 13¾ inches, dragon heart string. Let's give this one a try. Oh, goodness. Looks like it's back to the shelf for you. This is proving to be trickier than I had anticipated. How perplexing. Where are you? Perhaps you? There you are. Yes, I think you might be the one. Here, take it. What do you think? Extraordinary. Another wand, another beginning of a bright and magical future. Now, how did that feel?
Good. Different. I sensed a sort of surge of some kind.
A match. Your connection seemed particularly powerful. The right wand will learn from you, just as you learn from it.
I'm eager to try it out.
Of course. And a phoenix feather core is terribly selective. This will be an excellent match indeed. And the bond between you and your wand should only grow stronger. Do not be surprised at your new wand's ability to perceive your intentions, particularly in a moment of need.
That sounds wonderful, Mr. Ollivander.
I'll let you get to it. Do come and see me again if ever I can be of further assistance.
Revelio.
Welcome to J. Pippin's Potions.
Pardon me, sir.
Oh, thank goodness. When I heard the bell, I thought you were Miss Lawang. Not that she deigns to come here. Though, I don't believe I've seen your face here before, either.
It's my first time in Hogsmeade, actually.
Is it really? Well, Parry Pippin at your service. And this is J. Pippin's Potions. Potions for all ailments. You'll have read it on the sign, of course, but Grandfather always made me say it in full. How may I help you today?
Professor Weasley sent me to collect some recipes. I'm new at Hogwarts.
You're the student she sent the owl about. I set your things aside immediately. I suspected if you're anything like I was at your age, you'd want your potion supplies. Is it not the most fascinating art, potion making? Rivals anything you can do with a wand, I've always said.
Are potions really that versatile?
They may not be as showy as spellwork, but make no mistake, they are just as powerful. They can heal, destroy, protect. You'll discover all of this soon enough. As it's your first time in, I should mention that it's not just potion recipes I sell. I also offer ready-made drafts for all manner of uses, and I unveil new ones from time to time. Pop in when you can so you don't miss out on anything. But for now, let's get you those recipes, shall we? What can I do for you today? Feel free to take a look at the rest of my inventory, or come back another time if you're in a rush today.
Revelio. Accio. Revelio. Reparo. Levioso. Revelio. Lumos. Levioso. Revelio. Revelio.
My parents were thrilled to hear that rat was being put in trouble. If only Black had the power.
Revelio.
Attacked by a wolf.
Revelio.
An inquiring mind.
Revelio.
Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the spellcrafts Professor Weasley ordered.
Matilda, student. I thought I might be seeing you soon. I am the proprietor here, Thomas Brown. I take it you've had a conjuring lesson, then?
I'm afraid I haven't yet, sir.
Ah, but you will soon enough. It is magic at its purest, creating something out of nothing. Of course, it is not without complexity, but that is where my spellcrafts come in. Stay the course, and you could soon impress even Professor Weasley.
That's certainly something to aspire to, Mr. Brown. I look forward to that day.
And I, too, seeing it. Spellcrafts are incredibly useful for conjuring unique items like custom pieces of furniture or decoration. But I shall let Professor Weasley do the teaching. For now, let's get the spellcrafts you need. A potting table and a potion station. Yes?
I believe so, sir.
Good. Nothing like being able to grow your own ingredients and brew what you want, when you want. Let's have a look. Let's look at what we have, shall we? If you're interested, feel free to take a look around at the rest of my inventory.
Revelio.
Thank you.
Revelio. Repairer. Revelio. 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 Lumos. Revelio.
Lumos.
Lumos.
Levioso.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Accio. Lumos.
Sorry, I'm in a bit of a tizzy. I was just scolding some of the plants for spitting and nipping. I suppose it's my own fault for putting more than four to a tray. By the way, Beatrice Green is the name, but you may address me as Madam Green. Welcome to Dogweed and Deathcap. Oh, mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Oh, if there wasn't the constant demand for antidotes, I wouldn't need to stalk so many of the little dears. Except, of course, for curses. And, well, if you've been petrified, then obviously you've come to the right place. Mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Oh, if there's an uprooting, you'll be the next one to drop dead, and I'm in no mood for a clear-up.
What do you have for sale?
Well, what say we show you some of what's available? Well, what say we show you some of what's available?
I officially have all of my supplies.
Excellent.
Did you get what you needed for your sister?
I did. So I suppose the world is our oyster now. Let's see what else we can get up to.
We'll wear him down eventually. Accio. Leviosa.
What was that?
A taste of his own medicine.
Nicely done. Finger. That's right, you lumbering lout. He's faltering. Two more hits to do the job.
Goodness, a second troll. Did you two take on a fully grown troll by yourselves?
I suppose so. It's all a bit of a blur, to be honest.
Merlin's beard. Are you all right?
We are, and we were glad to help.
I'd say help is a bit of an understatement. Nerve like that. The makings of an aura, if you ask me. If you are unharmed, perhaps the two of you wouldn't mind helping me put a few things back to where they were.
Of course, Officer.
Singer. Officer Singer. And thank you, again.
Accio! Reparo!
Hello there!
I'll go and see what's wrong.
One less thing for Officer Singer to worry about.
Revelio. Reparo.
Mr. Hill was just singing your praises.
Hello, sir. I don't believe we've met.
Allow me to introduce myself, Augustus Hill, clothier extraordinaire. I should like to thank you for your remarkable bravery in fighting those trolls, and not to mention your help restoring Hogsmeade to its rightful state.
I was happy to help.
Frankly, you deserve an Order of Merlin, but I can offer you something much more useful. I own Gladrag's Wizardware, and among my inventory are some unique items that afford certain protections, as it were. Life-saving protections. And as I suspect this won't be your last dangerous encounter, I'd like to give you one such set of robes, in thanks for what you did today.
Thank you, Mr. Hill. That's very generous of you.
It's the least I can do. Now, let's try this on for size, shall we?
Plenty for your perusal today. Take your time.
I'd say we've earned a butterbeer or two, wouldn't you? Might help me forget that I was almost pulverized by a troll.
I'd say that I agree with you.
Perfect. The three broomsticks is just this way.
Nice hell, even.
Battle worthy. Rebellion.
Should you be inclined, you're most welcome to the room. At your leisure.
Assuming it isn't utter bedlam in there, we might even meet Serona, the owner. She's a good one to know.
You said you could get to the child when they came to Hogsmeade. That all you needed was a distraction. I gave you a distraction.
I just watched a student take down your distraction. Who's this child? What are you not telling me?
All you need to know is that if you cannot get to the child, then you have no value to me.
Did they see us?
I don't think so.
What was that goblin doing with Victor Rookwood?
Ranrock is working with Rookwood.
The goblin from the Daily Prophet. I knew I'd seen him somewhere. Quickly, let's get inside the three broomsticks.
It's a treat to see you, Lodgok. I shall let you know if I hear anything.
Thank you, Serona.
You be well. Now, what can I... Oh, there's a face I haven't seen before.
It's my first time here.
Welcome. Butterbeer's on me. Heard about the attack. I shall be looking in on the other shopkeepers and residents shortly. Glad to see you two escaped injury.
Thanks to this one. Single-handedly took down a troll.
Is that right? Well done.
Thanks for this.
My pleasure. I will say, trolls in Hogsmeade. That's never happened before. Something's not right. The only brutes we usually have to deal with are... How timely.
Was that Lodgok I saw leaving just now? Your clientele's not what it used to be, Serona.
Not to worry, Victor. Once the two of you leave, the caliber of my clientele will greatly improve. I wouldn't do that if I were you, Theophilus.
Come now. No need for theatrics. I'm only here for this one anyway.
My friend is enjoying a well-earned butterbeer.
Only want a quick word.
Perhaps you didn't hear me. I said, my friend is busy.
One would think you all had enough bloodshed for one day. Come, Theophilus. The Three Broomsticks isn't what it used to be. Let's take our galleons elsewhere. Can't drink butterbeer forever.
Seems you've made an unfortunate enemy. Watch your back. Rookwood and Harlow are worse than any troll you might encounter.
Trolls? Ranrock and Rookwood? What are you not telling me?
I promised to tell you everything, but it's perhaps best I do that later.
And on that note, I think we should head back to the castle.
Revelio.
I'm certainly glad Serona was there. Told you she was one of the good ones.
I can see that. She didn't seem at all intimidated by Rookwood and Harlow.
I think you'll need to tell me why Victor Rookwood has you in his sights. But we can talk later. For the moment, we should return to the castle. Professor Weasley's certain to hear about the troll attack soon if she hasn't already. Don't want to risk another detention for getting back after hours.